Hello, beautiful crochet lovers. I'm Susanna. Welcome to my channel. Today, I would like to show you how to crochet this beautiful flowery-like trellis stitch rectangular pattern. This is an arranged version of the rectangular, and this is arranged version of stitch of the trellis. And before starting this pattern, I would like to show you how to crochet just back and forth this pattern. This is the base of this pattern. When you crochet this pattern, you can move to the rectangular. When you start with the rectangular, when you want to start rectangular first, that is very, you know, difficult for you. So first, please understand this back and forth rectangular design pattern, and then let's move to this beautiful rectangular triangular pattern. Okay, and this back and forth design is not so difficult, so, and also very useful, so you can enjoy in many ways. And this rectangular pattern is also very, very beautiful, so you can make a, you know, table centers or a blanket, or, you know, like many things with you. So maybe you can make a like this. Wow, very beautiful, isn't it? So this shape is very beautiful, yet very, you know, open work. So it's very good for this season, from spring to summer to autumn. So please enjoy. Okay, so let's jump in. Stay tuned. Okay, this pattern is today I would like to show you back and forth and rectangular. All right, and for the back and forth, please remember the multiple of stitches is 8 stitches plus 9. So here, actually, this is a repeating of the 8 stitches, but when you repeat back and forth, we need 8 stitches plus 7. So it means from starting from here to the end, and plus 2 at the beginning. So it means a multiples of 8 stitches plus 9. Okay, so today I would like to repeat 2 times and 1. So I need 2 times, so it means 16 and plus 9 is 25. So I would like to start with 25 stitches for the foundation stitches. But if you would like to make something different one, please change your foundation stitches as you need it. Okay, alright. So first, we are going to study about back and forth. Alright. Okay, so I leave the diagram here so that you can check time to time online. Okay, so let's start. And so today I would like to repeat 2 times. So it means 8 by 2 is 16 and plus 9 is 25. So after making a slip knot, please make 25. Or if you want to make something different one, please calculate by 8 and plus 9. Okay, so make a slip knot. After making a slip knot, please make chain 25. Okay, a multiple of 8 stitches. In my case, chain 25. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is a multiple of 8 stitches. One more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, 16. So I would like to repeat 2. So we need 9 more. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And so now I made 25 chains. Okay, let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 25 chains. Okay, so let's start back and forth design. Alright, the first, we are going to start a double crochet and chain 1 and 3 double crochet together. Okay, that is a cluster. Okay, so that is a puff stitch of the double crochet. Alright, so when you want to make a double crochet, please alternate with chain 3. So please make chain 3, 1, 2, two, three. And we need chain one here, so please make chain one here, okay? Then please make three double crochet together into the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, fifth chain. So in that case, please pick two loops at a time so that you can the stitch will be stable, okay? So please make pull up a loop, three loops on the hook, yarn over, pull through first two loops, but do not finish. Yarn over again and into the same stitch here, insert, yarn over, pull up a loop here. So now 1, 2, 3, 4 loops here, yarn over, pull through two loops again. Now three loops on the hook, this is two doubles incompleted, yarn over, and then into the same stitch again and pull up a loop and yarn over, pull through two loops. So four loops again, four loops on the hook. So this is three doubles. So let's make into one. Yarn over, pull through these four loops at a time. Okay. So we did here, and we need to round with single crochet. Skip chain one and into the next stitch, make single crochet. So in that case also, please pick two loops and make a single crochet. Okay, then next is this loop means chain five, so please make chain five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, then please skip 1, 2, 3 chains and into the next stitch single crochet. Okay, skip 1, 2, 3 and this one, make a single crochet, pick two loops and single crochet. Okay, not to forget, let's mark the third chain. So this is the 1, 2, 3, the turning chain. Okay. All right, after single crochet, please skip chain one and into the next stitch, please make three double crochet together cluster and chain three and into the same stitch, make three double crochet together cluster. Okay, yarn over, skip one and into the next stitch, insert, and please make three double crochet and together four loops on the hook and pull through all, chain three, yarn over, back to the same stitch, make three double crochet together, four loops on the hook and pull through all, then skip one and into the next stitch, make single crochet, okay, like this. So this is the 8 stitches of from single crochet before single crochet. This is the 8 stitches. Okay, then repeat one more time, chain 5, skip 1, 2, 3 and into the next stitch, make single crochet, and 1, 2, 3 and single crochet, 1, 2, 3 and single crochet, and 1, 2. Okay, all right, so next is make a cluster. So yarn over, skip one and into the next stitch, make three double crochet together, chain three, yarn over into the same stitch one more time, skip and into the next stitch. Next single crochet. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2. Okay, so chain, okay, we did until here. So next is chain 5 and single crochet, and into the last stitch, 3 double crochet together, chain 1 and double crochet. Okay, chain 5 and skip 1, 2, 3 into the next stitch, make a single crochet. Alright, skip one and into the belly last stitch, please make 3 double crochet together again. 1 into the same stitch, 2 into the same stitch again, 3, 4 loops, pull through all and chain 1, and into the same stitch make a double crochet. That is belly quite, you know, tough. Okay, so this is the row one that we made here. So move on to row two. Okay, next is row two. Look at the diagram here. The row two, there is no stitches, just only chain 5. So that is very simple. Okay, so chain 1 and turning work, and into the last stitch of the double crochet, make single crochet and chain 5. Okay, next is chain 5 space. So in the space, make single crochet and chain 5, 4 and 5. There is a chain 3 space, make a single crochet, chain 5, into the next chain 5 space, make a single crochet and chain 5, into the chain 3 space, make a single crochet and chain 5. In the chain 5 space, make a single crochet and chain 5. And when you finish, please join into the very last stitch of the third chain. So 1, 2, 3, this one. So I marked, so you won't miss it. Okay. Single crochet and finish. Alright, this is the second row, and this is the long side. The light side is this cluster side, and this side is the long side when you walk back and forth. Okay, so please remember that. Alright, so moving to the third round. The third round, please look at the diagram here. We are going to start with the chain 5 spaces. So instead of chain 5, we are going to, or that we, because we have to, you know, divide into half. So the first is double crochet and chain 2 and single. The end with single crochet and chain 2 and double. So this is the, you know, the half chain 5 spaces loop. Okay. Alright, so first we need to double crochet and chain 2. So please alternate with chain 5. 1, 2, 3. Oops. 4, 5, and turning work. And single crochet into the next chain 5 space. Okay. At a time, please mark the third chain out as a turning chain. So let's count. 1, 2, 3, this one. So let's mark. Okay, the next we are going to make a cluster, the group cluster, chain 3 cluster. The cluster means 3 double crochet together. Okay, so when you want, when you make, please make into the single crochet here. So yarn over into the single crochet, so 3 double crochet, excuse me, something long. Okay, 3 double crochet together and 4 loops on the hook, please plus at a time, and then chain 3 and into the same stitch that we made, please make 3 double crochet together again. 1, 2, 3, the 4 loops on the hook and pull through all. Okay, then single crochet into the next chain 5 space. Okay, like this. Next is chain 5 and single crochet into the next chain 5 space. Okay, next is here is the single crochet, so please make 3 double crochet together. I call it a cluster and chain 3 and into the same stitch make another cluster. And pull through all. And into the next chain 5 space, make single crochet. Like this, so it's kind of, you know, zigzag. So next is here. Okay, so before that, please make chain 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And into the next chain 5 space, make single crochet. And into the next single crochet, cluster, chain 3, and cluster. This is the first cluster. And chain 3. And into the next same stitch, make another cluster. And pull through all, and then into the chain 5 space, make single crochet. Okay, then let's finish with chain 2 and double crochet. So chain 2 and into the single crochet, make a double crochet. So this is the third round, and fourth round is repeating row. So actually, even rows are only the plain trellis stitch. Okay, so let's make chain 1 and turning work and make a single crochet into the belly first stitch. And chain 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And into the next chain 3 space, make single crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Into the next space, make single crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Into the next space, make single crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Into the next space, make single crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Into the between the clusters, make single crochet. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And finish with single crochet into the third chain. So 1, 2, 3, this one. And make single crochet. So this is a row 4. And actually, it's a kind of the, you know, one pattern was finished like this. So the next round is a repeat as a first row, but please remind the first row we made of stitches into the chain, but the next row we are going to make cluster puffs or chain slip cluster in the single crochet and one by one, and the position is the same as here. So here and here and here. So in the row 7, we are going to make puffs or the cluster here, here, and here like that. So as you know, into every other rows like that, okay? All right, so let's do it or the row 5 together. So start with chain 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and turning work. And please make a cluster into the same stitch. And into the next space, make single crochet. Okay, next is chain 5. And single crochet. What's the next? Here is the, you know, I call it a shell. Here's a shell. So we need a shell here because we need a stolate, you know, because repeat of the first row. So into this single crochet, make a cluster. And chain 3 and make another cluster. And in the next space, make a single crochet. And chain 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And in the next space, single crochet, and next we need a cluster. So here, and chain 3, and into the same stitch, make 3 double crochet together. Pull through all, and in the next space, make single crochet and chain 5. In the same next space, single crochet, and I would like to finish. So let's find a chain, third chain. So 1, 2, 3, this one. Into the third chain, make a cluster first. And chain 1 and double, chain 1 and double. So now you can recognize the pattern will be okay. So next round, always same, even round. It start with single crochet and chain 5, repeat chain 5 and single crochet, and finish with a single crochet. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and in the next space, make single crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and into the next space, single crochet. Okay, so I skip this procedure. Okay, move to row 3. The row 3 is start with chain 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and turning work and single crochet into the next space, and then make a double crochet, 3 double crochet together in the next single crochet. And chain 3 and back to the same space. And single crochet, and repeat. Okay, then finish with chain 2 and double crochet into the first single crochet. So I repeated 2 times, so now you can see the stitches. I would like to show you a few rows more and then I'll see you later. Okay, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 rows. So when you want to finish, I recommend finish at the first row so that the shape is more, you know, many stitches in the edge and the evenly edges. So I prefer this, so I recommend this. Okay, so the shape is like this. So here, you know, it's kind of a at the other stitches, but actually not, but it seems like that. So it's very beautiful, isn't it? Okay, so this is our Trellis arranged stitch, and this is a back and forth design, and I would like to arrange into the rectangular. Okay, so please stay tuned. Okay, so let's move on to the rectangular, and this is the diagram, and this is the fabric that I crocheted. And the rectangular is multiple of 8 stitches and plus 1, and 2 rows repeating. And please look at the diagram here. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. That is a chain 5 spaces are 4. Per side, so it means 8 and 2 corners each, so it means 12 for the one round. In this case, the foundation chains are 17, that means 1, 2, 3, 4, and 4 is 16 and plus 1. Okay, so 2 spaces are 8 stitches. We need 2 stitches, 2 spaces for the first or first round. So if you want to increase, please increase 6 spaces, 8 spaces, and 10 spaces like that, blah blah blah. And when you decrease, start from 0 or 2. So 0 means square and 2 is the minimum rectangular. And today I would like to make 1, 2, 3, 4 spaces. This is the shape like this. And so the first round is even spaces, and the side is 0. And the second round, we are going to increase 1 by 1. So we are increasing 4 spaces in a total. So for the one side is it is 1, 2, 3, 4, but second round is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is odd numbers, and 1 here is the odd number. Okay. Alright. So and then when you make a puff stitches, or we are going to make a every even rounds. So odd rows is even and even, and even rounds is odd and odd and shell, right? So like that. Okay, anyway, I would like to show you how to crochet. So this pattern is this one, and 1, 2, 3, 4 spaces. So we need 17 chains. So please make a slip knot, and please make a 17 chains. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17. Okay, so the first or tricky point is the, you know, the foundation chains. The foundation chains should be the 8 multiples of 8 stitches and plus 1, or just magicling. Okay, the second tricky part is when we make a puff stitches only in the even rounds. Okay, so this is the first round, so just we are going to make spaces, chain 1, and into the second chain here, please make a single crochet. Okay, the third tricky point is the joining point. So for the rectangular, that is a very important point is how to start. So in this design, usually I recommend you to start from the space one, but from this pattern, I recommend to you to start the corner one here. So after single crochet, please make chain 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and back to the same stitch that we made single crochet. Okay, so this is the tricky point. Okay, then please make chain 5, 4, 5, and skip 3, 1, 2, 3, and into the 4th stitch, make single crochet. And chain 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and skip 3, 1, 2, 3, and into the next stitch, make single crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and skip 1, 2, 3, into the next stitch, make single crochet. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and skip 1, 2, 3, into the last stitch, make a single crochet, okay? So for the side, we made 1, 2, 3, 4 loops. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Then let's make corner. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And single crochet into the last chain here. And make single crochet. Okay. Then let's make another corner here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and back to the same chain and single crochet. So we made 2. And for the other side, let's make 4 spaces and single crochet into the same chain that I marked in red. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and this one in the same stitch. Single crochet and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Skip 1, 2, 3, and next stitch is the same stitch with the opposite side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and single crochet at the same stitch at the opposite side, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and single crochet into the last stitch, okay? So now we are going to make another corner, and you can see the mark like a T. This means it's a half double crochet. So when you finish, please make chain 3 and into the very first single crochet, make half double crochet. Then mark this stitch. Okay, so this is the first round, and this is the shape. So two corners at the end each, and four spaces each. So I made this one. Okay, move on to round 2. Alright, so round 2, look at the diagram here. We are going to make a puff stitches. It is, or you know, just before and after the corner. So now we are here, so we are in between these two corners, so we are going to make puff stitches here. All right. And this is the first single crochet that we are going to make puff stitches, and we land with the half double crochet as well. So for the first stitch, yarn over and into this single crochet that we joined, make 3 double crochet together puff stitch. Okay, 4 loops on the hook and yarn over, pull through all. This is the first puff stitch, and then chain 3 and back to the same single crochet into the stitch, make a puff stitch. after making the cluster here, so please make a corner. Into the next space of the corner, single crochet, chain 5. And back to the same space, make single crochet. The next is the puff stitch again. So puff stitch, space, 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 puff stitch, space. So every other spaces, please make puff stitches. Okay? So puff stitch shell. So in the next single crochet, make puff stitch, chain 3, puff stitch. After making this shell, into the next chain 5 space, make single crochet and chain 5. After that is just repeat the same thing, because this is the even rows has odd number spaces, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So when you start from the puff stitch at first, second is chain 5, third is puff stitch, fourth is space, and fifth is puff stitch. So you never make any mistakes if you follow this rule. Okay, so this is the next one, is the shell cluster, chain 3, and puff stitch. And in the next space, single crochet and chain 5. And in the next space, make single crochet. And next is a puff stitch. And this is the last stitch. And this is the both corners. So it's the same as the diagram. Chain 3. Like this, and at the corner please make a single crochet and please make corner here, chain 5, and back to the same space, make single crochet. Okay, finished. So I made 1, 2, 3 shells, 1, 2, 3 shells. Okay, next, here is the single crochet between corner spaces. So please make shell. Puff stitch, chain 3, puff stitch, cluster. And into the next corner, single, chain 5, single. And now came after the opposite side. The opposite side is also same, so after making a corner, please make puff, chain 3, puff, shell. One, two, three. And next stitch, make single crochet. So this is a corner, and then chain 5 and single crochet and repeat. So see you at the end of, okay, let's do it together, that is better. So next is chain 3 and double crochet 3 together, that is a double crochet puff stitch. and in the next space make single crochet and chain 5 and single crochet into the next space. And here is the last space and make cluster, chain 3 and cluster, puff, chain 3 and a puff stitch, a puff stitch and a single crochet. Okay, then let's join. So please look at the diagram here so you can see the half double crochet sign. So chain 3 and half double crochet into the marked stitch. This is the second round and this is the how to end. So now like this, and here is this one. Okay, this is the second round, so move on to the third round. The third round is only the spaces, so odd round is the spaces even for the sides and even for vertically, and no shawl. Okay, so start from chain 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and into the chain 3 space make a single crochet and chain 5, and into the next space make single crochet, and this is the corner. So we need to increase the single crochet. So after chain 5, back to the same space, make single crochet. Then chain 5. And into the chain 3 space, make single crochet. And chain 5. Into the next space, make single crochet. And chain 5. Into the next chain 3 space, make a single crochet. And chain 5. So repeat like this, it's very simple. Chain 5, into the chain 3 space, make single crochet and chain 5. And this is the corner, so please increase a single crochet and chain 5. And please make another single crochet in the same space. So there is 1 and 2 single crochet in a space, and then chain 5. And single crochet into the next chain 3 space and chain 5. And this is another corner, so please make another single crochet in a space. So in the same space, make a single crochet and chain 5. And in the chain 3 space, make single crochet like this, chain 5. And into the next single crochet, chain 5 space, single crochet. Chain 5, in the chain 3 space, chain 5, single crochet into chain 5 space and chain 5, single crochet into chain 3 space and chain 5, okay, into the next corner space, and you can see the marker, so let's finish chain 3. And half double crochet into the marked stitch. And move the marker to the half double crochet here. Okay, this is the row 3 and row 5, row 7, row 9, always same. Okay, so let's move on to row 4, round 4. Now I think you can recognize how is the shape is like this. It's a very beautiful and airy. Okay, so moving to round 4. The round 4 is making a cluster shell. So look at the diagram here. This is round 2 and this is round 4. Please look at the cluster space. Do they are same spaces? No, they don't. When you made chain 5 spaces on round 2, you need to make or cluster. When you made a cluster at round 2, you need to make chain 5. So it's the opposite way. So the rule is same. Please make a cluster every other spaces. But the position is different. But the basic rule is same. Always start from the core after the corner and always finish before the corner. But it is very natural because there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That is odd space. Okay? Alright, so let's do it. So this is now just after the corner. This is the corner, you see? So in the half double crochet here, you need to make a cluster. So puff stitch. And pull through and chain 3 and into the same stitch. Pull through, then into the chain 5 space, make single crochet, okay, and chain 5 into next chain 5 space, make single crochet. Okay, what's the next one? We just made chain 5, so we need to make cluster where this single crochet. And also this single crochet is belong to the corner, so this is the end of the side and we can finish with the cluster. So in the same in the corner single crochet. Okay, the first is one space, one cluster, and now is 2. And the next is 3, and the next is 4, like that. Please increase like that. 1 and 2, okay? And this is the corner, so chain 5. And back to the same space, make single crochet. And this is the corner, so that another loop is make a cluster. So into the next single crochet, make cluster. And chain 3 and a puff stitch. Into the next chain 5 space, make single crochet. Chain 5. Into the next chain 5 space, make single crochet. So this is not the same position because it should be here, but we didn't. We made chain 5 just above. It's the same as the, you know, the back and forth. So look at this here and here and back to here and here. So every other rows back to the same position. Okay. So next, there is no shell, so let's make a shell. And into the same next space. Okay, like this. So I think now you know what to do. We are going to make shell and make a shell into the last single crochet before the corner. Okay, and after the corner, please make a shell and then make shell before the corner and after shell, make a corner and every other spaces and finish with a shell before the last corner. Okay. Okay, this is the last corner, so please make a single crochet, then chain three, and into the marked stitch make a half double crochet, and then move to the next round. So please repeat like this. The loop is always the same, just making the same pattern that you can make the same, you know, design like this and this and this. Okay, so I'm gonna skip next round and see you at the next round. Okay, next is row six, round six, and round six is also same. Please make a start a cluster after the corner. So always the key point is the corner. The corner you have to increase, and after corner you have to start a cluster. That's it. It's not so difficult. Once you understand this loop, you can increase as many rounds as you want. Okay, so let's do it together. So this is after the corner that we joined, so we have to start cluster again. This cluster is a kind of a shell stitch. So puff stitch gently and puff stitch. Then into the next space, single crochet and chain five. So now, once you set the cluster, you just follow the loop. So it is very easy. You don't have to think much. Just according to the loop, you can continue the stitch, so the pattern will be appear. Like this. So we can finish just before the corner, because this is the even round, and even round has odd numbers of spaces. Okay, so I made 1, 2, 3 shawl and then 2 space, so it means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 spaces. And that corner, let's make the corner stitch. Okay, like this, please continue and please enjoy. Alright, when you want to finish, please make chain 5 and into the marked first stitch and join. So that you can finish at any timing. And I recommend you to finish after in a cluster round, so that the shape is more stable. And this is the, you know, the basic pattern of the shell rectangular Trellis stitch. Okay, how was it? Is it okay? Beautiful, isn't it? So compared to the first pattern, this is the first pattern. So the shape is here is almost the same, but the rectangular has, you know, four direction. So the back and forth is always same direction like this. The shell is always the same direction, but rectangular has four direction like this. This is to the upward, this is downward, this is side to side. So, and this can be, you know, expanding showing. So that is the most merit of rectangular. Rectangular is very beautiful because you can see the direction and to the four ways. Okay? Alright, how was it? If you like this, please subscribe my channel, and I'm very, very happy if you like my video. Okay. Alright, thank you for watching and see you next time. See you next time. Bye-bye.